to try the performance. Now please, put your hands together for tonight's host.
Yes, indeed. Ladies and gents, boys and girls, it's now showtime, part one. So please, put your hands together and welcome to the stage, the fabulous Simon Virtue!
Because my dad disappeared when I was nine. So it was look at me ever since that day. Now you've seen the birds, ladies and gentlemen. So you may be wondering if I'm going to put a rabbit out of the hat. The answer is no, but please do keep watching because I might pull a hair around my arse. There we go. Where's he going? I was off to have a chat with the staff. It's very nice, right? Sorry, I'm easily distracted, I warn you now. Now then, actually, I'll tell you the truth, actually. It was my dad's fault how I got into magic. When I was a youngster, Oh, he's back again. You're alright, mate. Yeah, you're okay. It's over here. I know, he's talking to his mate, so he's clearing his face on the dance floor. Yeah, okay. Oh, well, the other one's off now. Blimey, right, here we go. Anyway, back to the story. Anyway, when I was a young man, I was taken to a magic show by my dad. Now, in the magic show, there was a magician. What a surprise. And the magician had a little silver box. Now, it looked a little bit like this one, right? Now, you could see all the way around the outside. He opened up the doors. You could see all the way through the inside, right? He wiggled his fingers through the little doors and holes like that, snapped up the doors, snapped his fingers three times, reached inside the box and produced a handkerchief. And the entire audience there shouted out, "That's amazing." All right, here. He then got a big round of applause. Oh, it's getting louder, that's nice. They then cheered for more. And then there was a standing ovation. Anyway, I was impressed. I was only little, so I rushed backstage, banged on the door. I said to the magician, "Excuse me, how did you do that trick?" He said, "Which one?" I said, "The one where you had a little silver box. You could see all the way around the outside, all the way through the inside, wiggle your fingers with the little doors and holes like that, snap shut the doors, snap your fingers three times, reach inside the box and produce a handkerchief." And the entire audience there shouted out, "That's amazing." Give you a big round of applause. Then they cheer for more. And then there's a standing ovation. Or another cheer, which, oh, thank you, sir. Thank you. Well done. The check is in the post. It's a whole little. Anyway, he said, "Yes, mate, I got it from the magic shop in London." So we drove to central London in the middle of the night, found the shop, couldn't believe my luck, banged on the door very loudly. A man came downstairs, opened a door in his pyjamas. I thought, what a strange place for a door. I said, "Excuse me, do you sell that trick?" He said, "Which one?" I said, "The one where you've got the little silver box. You can see all the way around the outside, all the way through the inside, wiggle your fingers through the little doors and holes like that, snap shut doors, snap your fingers three times, reach inside the box and produce a handkerchief." And the entire audience there shouts out, then they give you a big round of applause, then they cheer for more, and then there's a standing ovation. For one man and one lady, oh, bless your hearts, thank you very much. For those of you that aren't standing up and joining in like this good family over here, just to let you know, I can actually do this 95 times until we get it right. It's going to be a very long show, this. He said, "Yes, mate, it's 50 quid, so guess what happened, can't you?" So, ladies and gentlemen of Shawfield, I'd like to start the show this evening with a little trick involving a little silver box so you can see all the way around the outside, all the way through the inside, wiggle your fingers on the little doors and holes like that, snap shut the doors, snap your fingers three times, reach inside the box and produce a handkerchief. And the entire audience there shouts out, then they give you a big round of applause. For more! And then there's a standing ovation! Yes, yes, that's it! Come on your feet, everybody! I'm standing! Cut, Courtney. Sorry, basically, what's happening here is it's the children and the drunk people. That's what's going on, I'll figure it out. Thank you, children, sit down. Bless you, thank you. When I was in the magic shop, the bloke said to me, "Would you like to learn how to do a magic trick?" So I said, "Yes, please." He said, "Right, to do this magic trick, what you're going to need is you're going to need a handkerchief, but you have to promise not to tell anybody how the magic is done, right? So what you do is you get a hanky, you put it through your hand, then you're going to squish the hanky into your hand nice and small, okay? You squash it nice and small in your hand, it doesn't go up your sleeve. You squash it nice and small like that, then you snap your fingers three times like that, and the handkerchief, bizarrely and strangely, changes into a red handkerchief, and everybody gives you a nice big round of applause because they put that hand in the air and you get a nice big clap. Now, he said to me, "Would you like to know how to do it?" I said, "Yes, please." He said, "What you're going to do is go to the shop, spend £5 on two hankies, right? You need two hankies to do this trick. You need a white one, that goes over there. That's the starter's trick. The red one, he said, is the secret hanky. This is called secret preparation. You're not meant to tell people this bit, right? You hide the red one. Now what you do to hide the red one, you squash it very small into your hand, right? So you squish it nice and small in your hand so that nobody can see it. That goes in there nice and small so no one can see it. Then, what you mustn't do is to show anybody the red hanky. Do not show them the red hanky, it will spoil the trick. You get the white hanky, you put the white hanky on top of the red hanky. Don't pull the red hanky out, then it gives it away, right? Don't drop it on the floor, spoils it completely. Squash the white hanky on top of the red hanky. Then, you can pull the red hanky out of your hand like that, wave it around, everyone thinks it's gone red. Then, hopefully, at that point, he said, everybody will put that hand in the air, everybody will put that hand in the air, and give you a nice big round of applause. Fantastic. Now he said to me, are you a member of the Magic Circle? I said, yes, I'm a member of the Magic Circle. I'm actually a member of the Secret Six. So secret, I don't know who the other five are, but I hope to meet them one day. He said, right, if you're a member of the Magic Circle, every show that you do, you have to do at least one classic of magic. You have to do the Magic Circle. So could we have some classical music, please? Now what you have to do, first of all, is you have to stretch it, okay? You have to stretch it, okay? Then you have to inflate it, so it looks a bit like this. Here we go. Look. Come on, Struth, look at that. Seen one that big before, Madam? Sorry, I'm just asking for a friend, that's fine. Now then, I noticed there's lots of little people here. So how about, boys and girls, how about we do some balloon animals? Should we do balloon animals? Yeah? Right, okay, because I learned this during lockdown. I was locked in the house, I had to learn something new. So here we go, boys and girls, mums and dads. Balloon animals, here we go, balloon modelling. Here we go, balloon, 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 balloon. Look at that, that's a worm. It took me ages to learn that one. I've got another one, you like this one, ready? Look at that! That's a caterpillar. Man's a genius. I also do impressions of balloons as well. I do impressions, ready? Robin Hood. I also do balloon vegetables as well, ready? So run the bean. I do a better one, you like this one, ready? Oh yeah. It's a French bean. I'm an international act, I'm out of work all over the world. Right, down there, here we go. I'm going to do a real one, here we go. Little twist round about here, little twist round about there, little twist round about there. Oh, hello, that's a poor one. Don't worry, it's alright, I do the impressions of balloons. A well-known book, Gone with the Wind. Sorry, love, did I wake you up? You're alright. This has got... And finally, a well-known pop song from the 1950s. You've got to be a bit older for this one. A song from the 1950s. Here we go. Nobody knows where my Johnny has gone. Throw it in. Don't touch it! It's dirty! You don't know where it's been?
Oakden.
How about I give away a balloon? Should we give away a balloon? Yeah, give away a balloon. Right, I'll tell you what we're doing. I'm gonna blow it up first, blow it up, then I'm gonna find something. Right, so here we go, stretch it, here we go, inflate it. Have you seen one that big before, madam? No, I don't know. Are you pointing at him? That man there, hello that man there, hello, what's your name, sir? Phil, nice to meet you, Phil. Phil, you're going to get the first balloon, Phil. All right. Now, what's going to happen, everybody, is I'm going to make a horrible noise with the balloon on the microphone. Sounds like this. Right. Now, Phil, when you hear that noise, I'd like you to shout out nice and loudly so that everybody can hear the name of the type of balloon animal you want me to make this balloon into.
You, right?
Now, Phil, you could say anything you like, right? You could say a bird, or you could say...
A dog.
Or you could say a caterpillar with 16 legs, or you could say...
A dog.
Or you could say a giraffe with a really tall neck, or you could say...
A dog.
Yeah, get the idea? Or you could go for Tyrannosaurus Rex with scary claws and scary teeth, or you could go for...
A dog.
Are you getting the idea here, Phil? Right, so here we go, boys and girls, mums and dads. Bingo silence in the room. Here we go, ready? Shh. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Phil, what would you like?
Now!
Don't cross for that. It's like you went to rehearsals or something. Right, here we go, mums and dads, boys and girls, here we go, live and in 3D, this is amazing, in 3D and in colour, Phil has of his own free choosing selected a dog. So I'm going to give you, live on stage, Phil, your very own balloon dog! Thank you. Look at that, Phil. That's a doggy running excitedly towards you. That's brilliant. If I go like this, Phil, whoop, that's a doggy on his back legs running towards you excitedly. That's good, isn't it? If I do one twist over here like this, Phil, that's just a dog that's excited, running towards you excitedly, Phil. I'm sorry. That's a dog with a big willy, kids. That's all right. I'll explain the jokes. I don't care. By the way, if anybody's interested, I do children's parties. If anybody's interested, 4-year-olds can come and hear us. we do impressions as well, Phil. We do impressions as well. As a dead dog. See, now it's funny.
Yeah, kill the dog and all the kids start laughing. That's nice, isn't it?
Now.
Yeah. You shouldn't be laughing at that. This is a family show, what do you stand out?
Stop it! Phil, I did promise you a balloon. Now, this might remind you of something, it might not. I don't know, I've got no idea. I'm going to give this to you. You couldn't do that. You couldn't do that if you practiced, could you? You couldn't do that. Right, Phil, I'm going to give you this balloon, because I did promise. That's for you, Phil. Please be careful. It might go off prematurely in your hand.
Oh, it has gone off prematurely in Phil's hands. Never mind, sorry about that. Don't worry, I'll put that in the bin. There we go. Oh, hang on. Hang on, Phil. Phil, don't panic. There's another bit. Come on! Stop it! Phil, I promise you... this might remind you of something. I don't know. I'm not saying anything. That's for you, Phil. Don't have a little hold on. Please be careful. They can just unexpectedly go off. Right, now, in actual fact, I feel mean. I tell you what, I've got a spare, Phil. Don't worry, I've got a special one for you, Phil. Here we go. I've got a special one for Phil. Oh, don't look so worried about this. All right, I've washed it out on Tuesday night, I'm sure, Phil. Right, here we go. Look, I'm going to show you. Phil, you're going to check this when I show it to you, right? It's different. Ready? Big breath. Here we go. Oh, hang on, there we go. I'm going to kill that cat, that's disgusting. Now then, the clever people will notice that this balloon is different. Not only is it different, it's also got stuff inside it, Phil. As well as the stuff, it's also got words. Now the reason it's got words in there is in case it bursts, all right? Because if it pops, then it'll swear on my behalf, saves time. Now, Phil, you're going to be the official inspector. Okay, relax, Phil, don't worry. I'm not going to ask you up on the stage or anything like that because I've seen what you're wearing. So, I'll maybe put a tie on. I'm going to come and see you, Phil. You get to check the balloon. That's you. You can stay there. That's lovely. Now, whilst Phil's having a look at the balloon, everybody, I've got something for you guys to have a little look at. It's over here. And here we go. Now, it looks like Harry Potter's magic wand, except Harry Potter is a fictional character out of a book. Oh, sorry. Right, now this is actually the health and safety carrier for a very sharp, very dangerous needle. Now, first of all, Phil. Oh, then, always Phil's got help. I like it when the helper's got help. That's good. Right, thanks, mate. I love that. There we go. Phil, first of all, is that a real balloon? That is a real balloon. Right, I'm going to park it just there very carefully because, Phil, you get to check the needle as well. Right, you can stay there. That's fine. Please be careful, I do joke, but this is sharp, this is real, so please be careful. But could you verify on behalf of everybody? Yeah, hold a bit there. I mean, generally, is that sharp? That is real. Did they draw any blood? No, then push harder. I'm joking, Phil. You can sit there. A round of applause for Phil, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic, look at that. Right, now, it is now time for the illusion of the needle going through a real balloon. Right, here we go. Or as the French would say, c'est une illusion au needle en ballon. Something like that, I didn't pay attention. Right, Phil, if you're really going to pay attention for this, keep one eye on the needle, one eye on the balloon. One eye on the needle, one eye on the balloon. If you're really doing that, this will be annoying. God bless him, he's coming. Right, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, the illusion of a needle going through a real balloon. People sometimes ask me, if the tricks go wrong. Yes, they do, Phil. I muck it up a lot. It's a comedy magic show. It's absolutely fine. Right, sorry, where was I? Oh, yeah, right, here we go. The illusion of a real needle going through a real balloon. Find the trap door. That will pop the balloon. Go through the second trap door. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the illusion of a needle going through a real balloon. Look at that. That's ridiculous. Save it. No, don't stop. Oh, yeah, damn it. Right, okay. Now, some people say to me, can the trick go wrong now? Yes, this trick could still go wrong now. The balloon could still burst. If that balloon was to burst, ladies and gentlemen, the needle would fly out at 45 miles an hour. It's quite fast, that, isn't it? Oh, sorry, Phil, you might like to know that. Sorry, I'll keep that. That's best news, sorry. That's the health and safety way, isn't it? We'll send it that way. So that's the illusion of the needle going right the way through the balloon. Bit weird. If I put a bit harder, that creates the illusion of the string going all the way through the balloon, which is all very, very odd if you think about it, ladies and gentlemen, because that's the balloon that Phil checked. That's the needle that Phil checked. That, therefore, must be magic! Bless you. It's like the chips have gone in, Phil. That's lovely, I'll be back. Right, hello, mate. Are you handing me stuff back? Oh, that's so lovely. Thank you. A 1-inch square of paper. Thank you. I was going to miss that when I got home because I count those all back in, you know. Right. And, great, he's got me another thing. Super. It's a short job. This is what you do. But I'll put that in the bin for you as well. There we go. Lovely. Now, actually, as there's loads of little people here, how about mums and dads? Is it alright if I do a quick trick with one of the children? Is that alright? Yeah? Is that okay? Right, we're going to go on a child hunting. Let's have a quick sweep. Right, I need to sit down on the floor for me. I'll come down and see you.
Right, let's have a little look. Let's borrow this glass. I'm coming to see you.
Right, here we go then. Here we go.
Right, let's have a look, see who we've got. So we've got ugly. I'm sorry! Thought you were going to mute it! Thought she was going to mute it. Never mind. Right, I'm going to come through the middle here. Hang on a second, let's have a look. Right, hands up who wants to help. Who's brave enough, stupid enough.
Hasn't come to know the film at all.
Let's have a little look. This is pretty. Ooh, hang on, the young lady over here. Grab hold of that for me, sweetheart. Stand up for me. Follow me up the stairs here. Bring the glass with you. That's it, up the stairs here, very carefully. We're going to go to the middle. When we get to the middle, everybody here is going to give you a nice big round of applause. That's it, stand over there for me. Lovely. Hello, what's your name?
Scott.
Elsie, this is Elsie. That's my name when I was a little girl. That's lovely. And how old are you, Elsie?
46.
This is lovely. This is Elsie. She's 46.
Looks a bit small if you ask me, but that's okay.
And Elsie, are you married?
No.
No, that's okay. Don't have to be these days. You got a job? I see. So no husband, no job. I think you should try harder, Elsie. Now, Elsie, are you going to help me with a little bit of magic?
Yeah.
Now, what we're going to do, Elsie, is I'm going to send you back into the audience in a minute, all right? What I would like you to do is to borrow from one of the grown-ups, all right? So preferably somebody you know, Elsie, but it doesn't have to be, okay? I want you to borrow a ring. You see, I'm wearing a ring. Right, so we want a wedding ring or a diamond or engagement ring or
a diamond ring.
Yeah, big sparkly one, yeah. And then we find the ring, right? You put it in the glass and then bring it back up on the stage, okay? Preferably something you know, but it doesn't have to be, okay? Are you ready, Elsie? Right, off you go. Here we go. Elsie's going to go. Here we go. I'll just make sure she gets down the stairs, okay? Here we go. Right, so basically, ladies and gentlemen, what I've done is I've taken Elsie, who's about 6 years old, and turned her into a thief. Brilliant, so I'll make my money. Right, so that was great. Is she on the way back already? Fantastic. Right, let's move over there. Here we go. Right, have we got one? So look, I'll pop it in there then. Oh, very good. Right, then we better have a closer look at this, but she better show everybody. Right, tell you what, I've got sticky fingers. What I'd let you do, Elsie, is tip it out and pop it there for me. Right, now let's have a look. Whose is this, please? Give us a wave. Where are we? Who is this? Oh, that lady there. There we go. Pretending she's one of the children. It's lovely. So there we go. Yeah, she was obviously very nervous. She has a lot of children. Who is that lady there, Elsie? Your mummy, right? Hello, mum. Thank you very much, mum. And look at that, Rosie. We managed to get a ring from mum. And well, it's a nice one, look, because there's a place where a diamond should go, so that's always nice. And oh, hang on a minute, there's an inscription. There's writing on the inside, Elsie. We'll have a little read, see what it says. It says, with love from all the boys at HMS Belfast. Funny message, isn't it, Elsie? I'm joking, of course, doesn't really say that. It has got something there, though. I didn't just make it out. It's like a ring, but it's got holes in it, and it's got one. Oh, hang on, I got it. We go, A-R-G-O-S. Well done, Elsie. You've gone for the top quality stuff. Well done. Right, Elsie, I want you to hold on to it. Do not let go. You've got to keep it nice and safe, because otherwise mummy will be cross, okay? I'm going to take the glass. We're going to get rid of the glass. We don't need that. What we do need is a magic wand, okay? We need a magic wand for Elsie. Let me find the magic wand, which is over here. There we go. We've got the magic wand right now. Elsie, with the other hand, you hold on to the magic wand for me. No, just from the ends. That's lovely. So Elsie's going to hold the magic wand in one. Excuse me, that's a hold it, not snap it. That's right, I've got another one. Don't panic, that's all right, that's an old one. Right, Darren, Elsie, hold up the ring with one hand. With one hand you hold up the ring, with the other hand you hold up the magic wand. Nice and nice. So she's going to hold the ring with one hand, the magic wand with... Elsie, will you stop breaking my stuff, please? Thank you. Hello, my name's Elsie, I'm a helicopter. Right, let me find another one. We've got a spare. Here we go. Right, the brand new aluminium reinforced metal magic wand. Nothing can go wrong with this. It's not possible. It's made of metal. Oh my god. What the hell are you doing now, Elsie? Right, now, Elsie, what you have to do is you have to hold that up. Whoa! Not up my nose, thank you. Hold the ring up with the other hand so everyone can see it. Hold the ring. Right now, Elsie, do you know any magic words?
No,
that's fantastic. We're going to use the magic words. No, I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. You're going to wave the magic wand. All right. Hi. What's your name?
Albert.
Oh, hello, Albert.
Albert, are you in show business?
No.
Then get off my bloody stage. Thank you for helping.
Off you go. I'm getting nasty after 9 o'clock. Right, now then.
Albert, I can see you.
There are two rules in show business, ladies and gentlemen. Number one is don't work with animals. Number two is don't work with children. Stupidly, I'm doing both. Something wrong with me. Right, I'm going to say 1, 2, 3, go. You're going to wave the magic wand. You're not going to put it up my nose. You're going to say your magic word, no. And I'm going to do magic. Are you ready, LC? 1, 2, 3, go. Whoa! She came out with Expelliarmus. Did you hear that? Expelliarmus. Oh, hang on, missed. Expelliarmus. There we go. Her mum's ring disappeared. Look at that, give her a big round of applause. Fantastic. Yeah, hang on. That's easy.
Hang on.
Albert,
sit down.
Thank you. Oh, well, that's easy. Who's that? It's your mother, weird looking mother, because you've got one there you borrowed a ring from, and then you've got a real tiny one. Oh, look, he's all excited. It's like he's on a bit of elastic. Your mum lets go and he goes, and then comes back. Brilliant. Now, anyway, now, that's the easy bit, making stuff disappear, easy peasy. The harder part is to make it come back again. Now, Elsie, do you think you could make the ring come back? No, don't worry. How about if I help you? Would that be all right?
Yeah,
okay, what we're going to do, we're going to get rid of that, okay, because that is obviously a rubbish magic wand. That is a bit wibbly-wobbly and caused some of the trouble in the first place. In my pocket, we have got some magic stuff that you need to make your mum's ring come back, otherwise your mum's going to be quite cross, isn't she? Yes, otherwise right, there we go. There's the magic stuff. Now, what we need to do this, Elsie, we need a new magic wand. That's what the matter is. We need a new magic wand. To do this, Elsie, you need the Simon Virtue magic wand. So what? A lighter. Now, children, do not play with fire in your accommodation, okay? Go to somebody else's accommodation and do it. It's a much better idea. Right, Elsie, that's you. It's fire, isn't it?
Can I have it?
Touch it. I'll do it. Here we go. Right, I bet they aren't going to do it. Yeah, let's sort of get the words right. Here we go. Right, now what's going to happen, Elsie, is we're going to do the magic. You're going to make your mum's ring come back. You're going to tell everybody it's your ring, and everybody here is going to give you a nice big round of applause. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And there we go. And Elsie, is that your mum's ring back on the chain?
Sit down.
Hang on, is that your mum's ring? No. Well, you've mucked it up then, haven't you, Elsie? Oh, no, hang on. If only we had something that key fitted, but unfortunately I haven't got anything like that. Well, I definitely don't have a little box with a little lock on it because I did not put that in place before the show started. And, oh, Elsie, hang on a minute. What's the chances that key fits that lock? What do you reckon? Should we try it? Yeah, right, come stand over here. Right, here we go. Come on. Does it fit that lock? We're going to give it a little try. Feel nervous. No, hang on, I'll do it that way. You're a box. It's a bit fiddly. Let's get hold of the key. Right, key goes that way. Right, ooh, hang on. It unlocks the lock. Right, very slowly, very carefully, open up the box. What's inside the lock? It's our mum's ring! She's done it! Look at that! Give her a big round of applause. I'll get rid of that. Yeah, take that back to your mum. And then, does she deserve a prize, boys and girls? Yeah? Right. Yeah, so give that back to your mum, then come back. Take it back, and then there we go. That's it. There we go. Oh, traffic jam. There we go. And then come back up here. Fantastic. So I think you did fantastic, everybody. She did good. She did very well. Come and stand up over here, because, now look. I've got one balloon left, so you've got a choice. You can either have a balloon animal, or you could hold a magic bird. What would you like to do? Hold the magic bird, right? Right, okay, come on, stand in the middle for me then. Face the front, smile, that's lovely. Then you just stick out a finger for me, not the one you pick your nose with. Oh, that's it, right, good, right. I'll go and get Psycho. There he goes. Right, now you have to keep nice and still. Now he's a bit tickly, right? He's going to climb on you. You keep nice and still. Here we go, up we go. Look at that, ladies and gentlemen. Give my magic assistant a big, big, big round of applause. Holding the magic bird. Wow, look at that. Hang on a minute. I've got another bird. Guess what you've got?
A
another hand.
Do you think you could... Ooh, you... Nothing to see here. Yes, it's real, everybody.
There we go. You're right. Do you think you could... Sit down! There's actual shit on the stage now, right? If you touch it, you eat it, you'll die.
It's like, the man is making it up. I think I'll go and check this out. Sit down, please.
Right, do you think
we're in big trouble now, do you think you can hold two?
No.
Okay, we're going to settle on one. Look at that, give her a big round of applause, fans. That's it.
Does she deserve a balloon anyway?
Yeah, I got one left, so here we go, we blow this up for you, nice and quick. Then we're going to get some grown-ups down, alright? So here we go. Oh, good, it's a big one. Right, here we go. We're going to do a little knock round about here. Look at that! I'm playing a tadpole. Right, here we go. Little twisty round about there. Little twisty round about there. Little twist. Got balloon arms here. We're moving to do this. Little twist there. 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 Now, are you ready for the silly ending? Here comes the silly ending. Right, Helen. What do you think that is? No, it's a balloon, silly, and it's for you. There you go. Give her a big round of applause! Give her a cheer! Fantastic, instant now. What a little superstar. Right, now, there we go. A little bit of fun for the children. There we go. I think it's time to find a grown-up. But before I do, one of the things that people ask me about after the show is my little feathered friends here. Because people don't realise until things like that happen that they are actually real. Now, people say to me, how come the birds don't fly away? Drugs. We have the drugs before the show here, but I don't think I'll come up. Actually, I'm going to come and see Phil, because you're the official inspector, so Phil, say a good man, pop a finger out, hold Macy still. She's lazy. There we go, she'll hop on you. Now, Phil, on behalf of everybody here, all the people at the back and that sort of stuff, is that a real bird?
Yeah, we're having a close look.
Is that a real bird?
Yes. I don't know why he's whispering. Maybe it's because he's got a bird on his hand and he's now suddenly very anxious. I don't know. Right, anyway, not to worry. Anyway, a bit of grown-up magic now. Now, to do grown-up magic, I do need the assistance of a grown-up, obviously. I need a man, but not an ordinary man.
No, no, I need a special man for this trick.
I need a man who's holding a white bird. So let me have a little look around here, Shoreview. Let me have a little look around. Oh, Phil! What's the chances? Come and stand up here, my friend. Up you come, up the stairs here. There we go, gently that's it. Bring your feathered friend with you. There we go, I'll find you some space. Come over this side for me, Bill. That's like all the way over there, my friend. Dodge the, I tell you what, I'll put it under the mic stand. Okay, can't slip up in it now.
I will do later, watch.
Right, now, Bill, that is a real bird, yes? Fantastic, I'm going to take her off of you because she's actually got some more to do with the trick. Sorry about that. There we go, but what's going to happen though, Bill, is you are going to be the star of the show in the grown-up department because you are going to do a card trick, right? So I'll get them out of the box for you. What I'd like you to do, Phil, take the cards, come and stand over here for me, just under the bag of cement, that's perfect, lovely. And what I'd like you to do, first of all, is to check those cards nice and thoroughly. Check them out, make sure they're a real pack of cards. Now, magicians are meant to have glamorous female assistants, aren't they, Phil? They are meant to have glamorous female assistants. So I'll tell you what, Phil, you give... Oh, he's picked one. I like this. He's actually... He's had his eye on somebody all week already. I like this. He's like... Right, go on, which one do you want, Phil? Which one? Well, this one here. Come on, this one here. Yeah, up you come. Give her a big round of applause, everybody. Fantastic. I like this. Voted on by popular demands. There we go, the stairs are over here. There we go, fantastic. Don't worry, love, it's alright. Not everybody's dressed up for the occasion, it's fine. There we go, up the stairs you come. There we go, come and stand over here for me. There we go, that's lovely. And everyone will give you a nice big round of applause. Yeah! Oh, now she's on stage, she's like, I think I'm going to get dressed now. Right, lovely. Oh, an incoming message. Student. Yes, mate, what's the matter? No. Sorry, you've missed your chance, but you've been very helpful. If you could just tidy up all the rubbish, I'll make it down here. That'd be brilliant. Thank you, mate. Right, here we go. Oh, bless his heart. He is as well. Oh, no, he's... No, better than that. He's just lobbing stuff at Phil. Brilliant. Right, there we go. It's not a game. Right, there we go. What? Look, Phil's bigger than me. I'll set him on you. Right, yeah, sorry. Hello, what's your name? Hannah. This is Hannah, everybody knows me. Now, Hannah, are you married or happy?
Neither.
Well, that bit of attitude there, neither. Don't ask me these questions. Now, Hannah, it would be very rude of me to... Oh, right, guys, sit down, please. Sit down, because I do get stroppy. And apparently, punching children is frowned upon. Hello, things have changed in my time. There we go. It's still good. Who owns this one, by the way? Is there an owner? Anybody own any claimants before I get Larry? Could you reclaim your child, please? There we go. Because I have got a staple gun in the back of the box. I might use it. But, sorry, Hannah. Hannah, it would be very rude of me to ask you your age in front of all these people, wouldn't it? That would be very rude. So, Hannah, how much do you weigh? That's just as cheeky, isn't it, Phil? That's no good. But anyway, so Hannah, have you ever been a magician's assistant before? Never ever. Have you been a magician before? Never ever. Is there any magician in you at all? Do you want some? Okay. It's a night out for me as well, Phil. You've got to make the most of it. Don't worry, Hannah. It's all right. I thought of this. Don't panic. I brought a spare costume for you. So if you'd like to slip into the costume, Hannah, we'll get on with Phil's trick. Phil's going to do a trick. We've got Hannah. She's got the costume. Yeah, you know how to work it. That bit goes down there. That bit goes... Well, do you work it out? Phil's going to do some stuff. Right, Phil, what I'd like you to do is to count 10 playing cards face down, nice and loud, in my hand so that everybody can hear you. Okay, off we go. Here we go. In the hand. Here we go. Right, off we go. Cool. Yeah. Fantastic. Did you hear that, ladies and gentlemen? Yeah, very good. Right, we'll just recap. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Fantastic, that's good. Now, Phil, first of all, did you check these cards? Did you check them? Yes, good, I like that. He's thinking about it again. Yes, I did ask you to check them. Did you shuffle them? Good, okay. Now, Phil, have you got a pocket or a safe place? Yeah, okay, right. Take the 10 cards, pop them in your pocket or safe place. I'm going to take the deck, give the deck to your glamorous assistant, Hannah. Hannah, I'd like you to do exactly the same thing, please. Count 10 playing cards into my hand nice and loudly so everybody can hear. Okay, off you go. Did you all hear that, ladies and gentlemen? It was pretty good. We had it in stereo for a bit there. Right, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 cards. Fantastic. Now, Hannah, have you got a really safe place that you can put those 10 cards where I couldn't possibly get to them without you knowing about it?
Mom, that's my 10 cards.
I feel somebody shooting up. All I can hear behind me was, Brilliant. Right, now, you've shit, right, look at you. Right, now what's going to happen, Hannah, you haven't put the costume on. It's too, oh, don't need to show off, love. All right, there we go, it's too small. Right, okay, that's a pity, because I've been looking forward to the bit where the costume goes on. Phil, if you can put the costume on, we'll get on with the trick, there we go. I like that, he's going behind the curtain, so we can't see. It's like when ladies go swimming on holiday, isn't it? It's brilliant. You're basically nearly naked in your underwear, which is basically a bikini's underwear, isn't it? You go in the water, it all goes see-through, but what do ladies do, like, later on, is they put a towel around something, it's too late, right? It's still. And then you put a dress on, don't go, yeah, but I saw it this afternoon in the swimming pool. Anyway, sorry, there we go. Don't mess with Phil, he gets very stroppy. Right, here we go. Oh, what's this, someone... No, I can't have it now. I was going to smash your face in with it, but now you want it, I'm going off with it. Oh, no. Right, anyway. What is he doing? Yeah. Can I have 2 pints of what this kid's had, please? Because I'm telling you, I'll speed this up. Right, you're not wearing that either, right? Oh, my God, he's been kidnapped now. No, put him down. Oh, my, how strong is he? Jeez. Wow. It's like Mr. Muscles down here. Oh, Cryosan. Got him. Yeah, sit on it, just sit on it, it'll be fine. Right, anyway, what are we going to do? Right, you're guarding 10 cards. 10 divided by 2 is 5. That's lovely. Phil, we're going to... Yeah, okay, we've got 5. And tell me number between 1 and 5. Number between 1 and 5. 3. We're going to... Oh, look, that he spoke to the hand. That was brilliant. There you go. Right, we're going to move 3 cards. Should we do this visibly or invisibly, Hannah? Invisibly, I like that. That's the magical way. Right, what's going to happen is I'm going to snap my fingers. When I snap my fingers, my magical powers are going to fly out of my hands, right? Hannah, you may feel a small tingling sensation. Excellent. We're waiting for one of those all week. Phil, you're not going to feel anything. Right, here we go. On the count of 3. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Ooh. you feel that? Nothing. Yeah. Oh, that's disappointing. Phil, did you feel that?
Yeah.
I'm married to Nan.
Ouch.
Ouch, right, okay, there we go.
All right, Phil, I'll keep that for as long as I can, mate. All right. Right, and but weirdly, three cards have become invisible. Phil, I'd like you to dive in your pocket and take out one invisible playing card, please. Just one. Hold it up, show it to everybody. That's lovely. Pop it in my hand. There we go. That's super. Can you see that? That's lovely. Hannah, if you could take that, please. That's proving you're as mental as Phil and me. There we go. Lovely. Hold it up, show it to everybody, and then add it to the others.
Perfect. Phil likes that bit.
Right, Phil, could we have invisible card number two, please? Invisible card number two. Pop it in the hand when you found it. There we go. Show it to everybody. Very good. Look at that. There we go. Hannah, if you can take that. Hold it up. Show it to everybody. Fantastic. Do a little twirl like assistants do. Now do the Hey Macarena. Hey Macarena. I'm joking. Just show it in the top left. Oh no, don't worry, you're on Facebook Live. Look at that, look at that. Like a row of teenagers with phones over here. It's brilliant. There we go. Oh, by the way, I am on social media. If you want to join me on Twitter, Twitter, or whatever it's called now, X, you can poke me or whatever it is they do on there. So it's just at Simon Virtue. I'm also on Bookface. I'm very good at that one as well. It's at Simon Virtue Magician. What's the other one? Oh, Insta, I'm on that one. It's all the same thing, isn't it? At Simon Birch. I'm doing the publicity now, Hannah. It's right. Sorry, we're going to do the grand finale now. Phil, you're going to steal the show. I'm not going to touch anything. I want you to dive in your pocket, take out one more invisible card. I'll move this out of the way. Hold it up. Show it to this very lovely audience here. Hand it to your glamorous assistant, Hannah. Hannah will take it up. She will hold it. She will show it to everybody. She will do the YMCA. Why? Oh, I'm joking, love. It's all right. Just pop it in the top. There we go. He likes that bit. Right, there we go. Lovely. Right, now, Phil, we've got to find out if this has worked. So if you can dive into your pocket for me, please, sir. Pull out all the cards. Then what I'd like you to do is to count them nice and loudly on my hand so that everybody can hear. Okay, off we go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Sorry, hang on, that was weird. We've got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. He's telling the truth. Anything left in there? Nope. Just we're not doing the elephant joke. Stop right now.
Right, Hannah. We'd better find out how many cards you're guarding. So if you could take your top off, we'll see how many you've got. Sorry. I'm moving your mind. Sorry. Right. Just count them in my hand. Just count them in my hand, Hannah. Off we go. Nice and loud. If you need marriage counselling, come see me later, mate. Right, now, unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, we've nearly run out of time, so what we're going to do in just a second is we're going to pop some music on. When that music is on, if you want to clap your hands to the music, that would be lovely. If at the very, very end you want to cheer for more, that would be... There isn't any, but if you want to cheer for more, that would be awesome. Could we have that little bit of music, please?
So it's now time for Showtime Part 2. Please welcome to the stage.